Book 1 of Confucian Analects. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information, or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Recording by Li Jing. Confucian Analects by Confucius. Translated by James Legge. Lunyu. Confucian Analects. 学而第一. Book 1. 学而第一章子曰学而时习之不亦乐乎有朋自远方来不亦乐乎人不知而不愠不亦君子乎。Chapter 1. The Master said, "Is it not pleasant to learn with a constant perseverance and application? Is it not delightful to have friends coming from distant quarters? Is he not a man of complete virtue who fears no discomposure, though men may take no note of him?"
第二章。游子曰：“岂为人也孝弟，而好犯上者鲜矣；不好犯上而好作乱者，谓之有也。君子务本，本立而道生。孝弟也者，岂为人之本与？”
Chapter 2. The philosopher Yo said, "There are few who, being filial and fraternal, are fond of offending against their superiors. There have been none who, not liking to offend against their superiors, have been fond of stirring up confusion. The superior man bends his attention to what is radical. That being established, all practical courses naturally grow up, filial piety and fraternal submission. Are they not the root of all benevolent actions?"
第三章子曰巧言令色鲜宜人
Chapter 3. The Master said, "Fine words and an insinuating appearance are seldom associated with true virtue."
第四章曾子曰吾日三省吾身为人谋而不忠乎与朋友交而不信乎传不习乎
Chapter 4. The philosopher Zeng said, "I daily examine myself on three points. Whether, in transacting business for others, I may have been not faithful. Whether, in intercourse with friends, I may have been not sincere. Whether, I may have not mastered and practiced the instructions of my teacher."
第五章子曰 道千乘之国,敬事而信,节用而爱人,使民以时.
Chapter 5. The Master said, "To rule a country of a thousand chariots, there must be reverent attention to business and sincerity, economy in expenditure and love for men, and the employment of the people at the proper season."
第六章子曰 弟子入则孝,出则弟,谨而信,反爱众,而亲仁,行有余力则以学文.
Chapter 6. The Master said, "A youth, when at home, should be filial, and, abroad, respectful to his elders. He should be earnest and truthful. He should overflow in love to all and cultivate the friendship of the good. When he has time and opportunity, after the performance of these things, he should employ them in polite studies."
第七章子夏曰贤贤易色事父母能竭其力事君能治其身与朋友交言而有信虽曰未学吾必为之学矣
Chapter 7. Zixia said, "If a man withdraws his mind from the love of beauty, and applies it as sincerely to the love of the virtuous, if, in serving his parents, he can exert his utmost strength, if, in serving his prince, he can devote his life, if, in his intercourse with his friends, his words are sincere, although men say that he has not learned, I will certainly say that he has."
第八章 子曰君子不重则不威学则不固主忠信无有不如己者过则勿惮改
Chapter 8. The Master said, "If the scholars be not grave, he will not call forth any veneration, and his learning will not be solid. Hold faithfulness and sincerity as first principles. Have no friends not equal to yourself. When you have faults, do not fear to abandon them."
第9章, 曾子曰, 慎终追远, 明德归后矣.
Chapter 9. The philosopher Zeng said, "Let there be a careful attention to perform the funeral rites to parents, and let them be followed when long gone with the ceremonies of sacrifice. Then the virtue of the people will resume its proper excellence."
第10章, 子禽问于子贡曰, 夫子至于士邦也必闻其政求之于以与之于 子贡曰,夫子温,良,恭,俭,让,以得知夫子之求之也,其主亦乎人之求之与?
Chapter 10. Zi-qing asked Zi-gong, saying, "When our master comes to any country, he does not fail to learn all about its government. Does he ask his information, or is it given to him?"
Zi-gong said, "Our master is benign, upright, courteous, temperate, and complacent, and thus he gets his information. The master's mode of asking information, is it not different from that of other men?"
11章, 子曰, 父在,观其志,父末,观其行, 三年无改于父之道,可谓孝矣. Chapter 11. The Master said, "While a man's father is alive, look at the bent of his will. When his father is dead, look at his conduct. If for 3 years he does not alter from the way of his father, he may be called failure."
12章, 游子曰, 礼之用何为贵? 先王之道思为美, 小大游之。 有所不行,知和而和,不以礼节之,亦不可行也.
The philosopher Yo said, "In practicing the rules of propriety, a natural ease is to be prized. In the ways prescribed by the ancient kings, this is the excellent quality, and in things small and great we follow them. Yet it is not to be observed in all cases. If one, knowing how such ease should be prized, manifests it, without regulating it by the rules of propriety, this likewise is not to be done."
13章,游子曰,信敬于义,言可复也,恭敬于礼,远耻辱也,应不失其亲,亦可宗也.
Chapter 13. The philosopher Yo said, "When agreements are made according to what is right, what is spoken can be made good. When respect is shown according to what is proper, one keeps far from shame and disgrace. When the parties upon whom a man learns are proper persons to be intimate with, he can make them his guides and masters."
14章, 子曰,君子食无求饱, 居无求安, 敏于事而慎于言, 就有道而正言, 可谓好学也矣.
Chapter 14. The Master said, "He who aims to be a man of complete virtue, in his food does not seek to gratify his appetite, nor in his dwelling place does he seek the appliances of ease. He is earnest in what he is doing, and careful in his speech. He frequents the company of men of principle, that he may be rectified. Such a person may be said, indeed, to love to learn."
15章, 子贡曰,贫而无产,富而无骄,何如? 子曰,可也,未若贫而乐,富而好礼者也。 子贡曰,诗云,如切如磋,如琢如磨,其斯之谓与? 子曰,次也,时可与言诗以义,告诸往而知来者。
Chapter 15. Zi-gong said, "What do you pronounce concerning the poor man who yet does not flatter, and the rich man who is not proud?" The master replied, "They will do,
but they are not equal to him who, though poor, is yet cheerful, and to him who, though rich, loves the rules of propriety." Tsz-kung replied, "It is said in the book of poetry, 'As you cut and then file, as you carve and then polish.' The meaning is the same, I apprehend, as that which you have just expressed." The master said, "With one like Tsz, I can begin to talk about the odes. I told him one point, and he knew its proper sequence."
16章 子曰, 不患人之不己知, 患不知人也。
Chapter 16. The master said, "I will not be afflicted at men's not knowing me. I will be afflicted that I do not know men." End of Book 1. Recording by Li Jing.